Good morning. So really been chasing the Lord's peace every day and just asking for power and for healing and just for guidance, kind of some of the same things as usual, but I have this thing in my eye and it's been driving me crazy. Here, check it out. And it's not pink eye, it's just every time I put my contact in, it goes crazy. And I kind of need my contacts for a bunch of things that I really are some most temporally joyful things in my life, like going to Krav and I go do some fighting, and so you can't really fight with spectacles on. I had an improper rehearsal last night, just had to wear my spectacles, and I even just put a sash over my eye to keep it closed. I might get an eye patch, maybe. And I have a show today, and I have an opening show on Friday, and I just... Oh, and I got to shoot this week, and direct some stuff this week, and just have a lot of things on my plate that I'm very excited and feel very blessed about to have in my life. And having 1.5 eyes is, it's very distracting. My afflictions don't weigh up next to a lot of afflictions, but man, this is a terribly distracting one, and it's pretty painful. So I've been praying for peace, and I've also been charged by it a little bit, because I guess, as with all affliction, it turns my eyes, literally, it turns my eye, anyway, this is the good one, towards him, and towards the hereafter, towards that which dwells beyond this place, you know, because, well, really, almost any time things don't work well in this earth, I mean, there's some let's get her done type folks, I suppose, who are like, well, let's devise a plan to solve this issue. And I'm sort of that guy, but not really. So, being discomforted and finding no rest from it here, to me, my bulwark and the only place I can find peace is in him. And man, I was pretty much focusing on that. So I was like, I'm still confused and I still keep asking God. I'm like, so what's this about? Just to do it more? Or is this just one of those things that I've done something foolish with my eye, and you let us do a lot of just foolish things with our bodies, and this is some mere temporal preoccupation? And I don't really know. But in as much as it has sent me out of considering the physical realm at all, because the physical realm is really just annoying me right now, and it's also letting me know, again, how insufficient I am to even get simple things done, because my eye hurts and I can't do simple things, like look at things or walk around in the sun. Oh man, wait, what was I gonna read? Man. Great. Well, I left it open to this page, so I'm gonna just start reading in silence now until I find it. You guys can sing, or hum, or snap your fingers. Feel free. Well, there we go. I just moved the page. Foolish, foolish, foolish. Matthew 11:28. I've read this one before, but I just love it. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. So in a way, my minor affliction should actually has a bit, getting out of my own self and my own consideration is a tricky bit, but has cast me somewhat closer into that realm of A, feeling very grateful that this thing that's really, really bothering me is really just my eye being crazy. It's not filled with cancer and swelling out of my head. It's not being pecked out by birds because I'm too weak to flash the little birds away with my hands. So indeed, not only am I physically blessed, but it calls me inward to see how light my soul can be. So this can trouble my heart a bit, but my soul thus far has remained unshaken. Because it's on a firm foundation, you know? So that even this silly affliction of my eye, which is then casting me into all this, like, frustration about career-y stuff and the work of my hands on this plane. But it just made me extra grateful. I was like, man, at least my insides are knit together. Not even my guts, necessarily, but the inside of me that will exist all in all forever is knit together by the hands of a gracious and loving God. And thank goodness I have peace in my soul about my place in this world. And when I can't sleep at night, it's no struggle with torment in my soul, or, you know, trouble in my heart, or fear of myself, or God, or eternity. It's really just because my eyes bother me, and I sleep with my eyes slightly open sometimes, and so it just gets worse, and then the dogs are barking. Those are petty, petty problems indeed. And still, I come to him even in these minor afflictions, because, you know, it's all relative, I suppose, affliction. But I'm learning to just thank God for all manner of suffering, whether physical or emotional or what have you. That it might continue to just make me grateful. Make me grateful for what it is not, and make me grateful for the fact that I only suffer temporarily, and that his peace dwells within me, that I might remain joyful despite the fact that, you know, the human in me just wants to rage. But I've taken up his burden and pursuing in humility at the feet of the cross of the Most High is actually it is a light place to be. And even though my body struggles, my spirit dwells in joy and in worship. So that's all I got to cling to, and I'm going to cling to that, because, man, that does feel good. This does not. This does. That's all I'm thinking about. Guten Morgen.